Petrol prices have been pretty steep lately, but according to the government, there's no need to chuck away your keys just yet because some relief is on its way. The 44 cents per litre fuel excise has been slashed in half, but the reduction won't be seen at the bowser for another fortnight, potentially longer in regional areas, and it's only temporary. In September, the government's support will end.
Petrol prices are so high, everything's, you know, living is so high.
The budget also affects 6 million Australians on welfare who will get a one-off cash payment of $250. The money will flow automatically into bank accounts in April if you're eligible.
I like the idea of more money for the pensioners.
It wouldn't change my vote.
Another 10 million low and middle income earning Australians will also get a financial boost. Under the tax offset scheme, they can already pocket $1,080. That'll increase by $420 at tax time, totaling $1,500. There's a catch though. The scheme will wrap up altogether this year.
It takes more than that to change people's lives, especially when they've been affected by COVID and the floods.
There's only a few big ticket announcements in this budget for young people, a new apprenticeship program and an extension of the first home buyers scheme, but it may not make a difference with houses unaffordable for many. There was nothing in terms of new university or TAFE funding, and the bleak reality is the budget bottom line means future generations will be paying back the nation's debt for years to come.
I think it's management of the economy is a big issue for me and for the future.
The paid parental leave scheme is getting a big shake-up. Instead of two separate payments, the government's going to merge the dad and partner pay scheme and parental leave pay, creating one big pool of 20 weeks leave, which can be split any way you like. It's also open to single parents. The government says 2,200 families will gain access to the scheme for the first time at a cost of $345 million. The changes come into effect no later than March next year.
If they can afford it, extra cash is always welcome.
But with all this spending, there have to be cuts, and there's a $3 billion black hole in the budget. Labor's warning that's likely to be the cuts that haven't yet surfaced, but the government's suggesting that's spending that will become clearer during the election campaign. Shubha Krishnan, SBS World News.